Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back. My name is Trago, and this is the second chapter of my Ashes of Ariandel playthrough. As you can see, I'm starting out by the Corvian Settlement bonfire, and in the last video, we picked up a few weapons. One of those was Follower Saber, another one was Millwood Battleaxe. I've upgraded to a Heavy plus 10. It is actually amazing. Does quite a bit of damage, so I've been pretty happy with it. I used it on my strength build. You know, this is going to be another build incorporating strength. So, if you're looking for some good smaller weapons to go along with some of the bigger weapons you may have, go ahead and consider that weapon. It is really, really good. And here for this part. This is one of these Corvian Knights. These guys are fairly tough. If you're not careful, they can hit you for a lot of damage, so. And I was able to get him there. Yeah, let's see. I got the blessed weapon. And I actually got a couple of chimes as well that I can use. Now, the reason why I keep those even for a lower fate build is the weapon art gives sort of like this replenishment effect. Very useful to regain small amounts of HP. Yeah, and these guys are super annoying here. They got their little trap set up. Next weapon I'm picking up is the Crow Talons. And let's see here, Large Soul of Unknown Traveler. Gotta have to make a couple of runs through this area just so I pick up every item available. There will be a few enemies up across the way. Now, these Crow Talons are actually another weapon that received, I guess, a stealth nerf, as you would call it. The damage dropped off very slightly with the most recent update, which I'm not sure if it was due to the fact that they mentioned it wasn't performing quite as intended. I suppose it had damage animation similar to fists. Correct me if I'm wrong on that one. I am not entirely sure. I'm just working off based off the Japanese description that they had for the issue. So. I might not be 100% correct on that. Now, how'd you get here? You must have dropped down from below, from above. Alright, and just make another run through here. Let's see, I don't think there's anything in this room. And as I was mentioning in the last episode, guys, I cannot recommend the mace enough for any of you guys who are using a strength build. Even for hybrid builds, it's a very good weapon just because it does not require a whole lot of stats, and it has a really freaking good weapon art. That's Perseverance, and what Perseverance does, it pretty much just enables you to trade hits. Makes it quite easy to do so, and works really well even against larger weapons, so give it a shot, guys. Slave Knight armor, that's the same stuff that the NPC in the beginning of Ashes of Ariandel wears. You can meet him in Cleansing Chapel over in Cathedral of the Deep. Pick up a dark gem. I do believe this DLC has one of every kind of gem, so for any of you that are looking to infuse your weapon, make sure you pick all of them up. I know we've picked up poison, blessed, hollow, heavy gems in a previous episode, and this one's dark. Also simple as well. So yeah, you do get pretty much every type of gem in this. So here I'm going to switch out to the silver cat ring. I am expecting to be dropping from a pretty significant ledge here, and there's going to be another one of those Corvian knights up ahead of us, as well as a crystal lizard. Let's see, I'm not sure if I was able to avoid that Corvian knight. He's right below me. Should I fight him, or do I not even bother? Let's revisit this part a little bit later. There's still going to be a couple of Corvian knights for me to fight. Both of them are in this building, actually. And also, some more of these trees from the first episode. I'm just gonna clear out this area. Yeah, 471 attack rating with the mace. Pretty fucking good. You can go ahead and open the shortcut here. Now, over here, as you can see, one of these Corvians is up in the attic. And there's another one of them patrolling the area. And the guys with the talons are actually fairly easy to backstab because they go on these attack combos. Makes it very easy to hit him from behind. So apparently these guys, I don't know why he was trying to do all this jumping, up and down shit. But it did not work out for him. Alright, and over here, new miracle, Way of the White, Corona. Actually, they buffed it in a recent patch. Not exactly sure if it's going to be any good still, but... so far, I've tried it on my Faith build, and to be honest with you guys, was pretty underwhelming. It doesn't do enough damage in PvE to warrant its use over other miracles. And in PvP, I mean, you have to catch somebody. Like, somebody will pretty much have to be trying in order to get hit by that. So, not viable at all in PvP, at least in my opinion. I don't know, some of you guys might have better experiences with it, but... I'm big on using faith builds, guys, and to be honest with you, there are only a couple of miracles that I find usable. So, yeah, I forgot about this guy. And I better switch to Hornet. And I know he was trying to heal. He actually has a healing miracle that he will cast. So I was just trying to prevent him from doing so. You do pick up his weapon, and it's the Onyx Blade. And this is an amazing weapon for a Pyromancer. As you can see, it has pretty low stats. Does have high weight, but it's a great sword. Weighs just as much as the Claymore, as you can see. But only 14 strength, 12 dex, and... 15 intelligence, 15 faith, which is, this is of course what you'd be using if you are running a Pyromancer build of any kind. I'm just going to go ahead and no man left behind. Oops, made a mistake there and buffed right in the dude's face. He almost bled me right here, but I got a sharp gem for my troubles. You can farm these Corvian Knights for sharp gems. I tend to see that the drop rate for those is higher from Corvian Knights as opposed to skeletons in the catacombs of Karthus. So that's probably your best bet. And also, the Millwood Knights present an easier farming opportunity for heavy gems. So, just something to keep an eye on. I bow the one. Tis good. Tis good. I promise them. Tis good, the door. Right, and this right there was Gael's niece. She's drawing up her own painting. Over here we got a bonfire. Let's go ahead and open the shortcut. Yep, now moving on. Gonna be quite a few of these follower soldiers. Again, enough. Another reason why I like the mace. Very, very easy guard breaks. Very easy. Okay, And there will be a ton of these follower soldiers. Again, with these guys, you kind of want to just take them out one by one. Don't want to have them all gank on you. They're not difficult at all if you fight them solo, but if there is a bunch of them, just like with any other enemy in the game, you want to split them up as much as you can. I do love their armor. They kind of have this northern set. I wish it offered a little bit more defense. It's pretty light, so the poise and it is pretty weak. And almost bit it there. It's kind of a careless play on my part. And I better check the top side first. I'm sure there's going to be an ambush. You guys can see they're practically everywhere. Over here, we get the follower shield. Fairly light, but it's not very good. It doesn't have the 100% physical defense. Not expect that guy to do the jump and attack on me, but whatever. Worked out regardless. Yeah, I do believe there's gonna be a couple of these guys here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I got their whole set now. This fire breath attack is pretty annoying. Gotta say, guys, I'm pretty sure I killed most of them. This is going to be the first shortcut. Just going to go ahead and unlock it real quick. takes us all the way to the room of Kale's niece. Sure, I have a couple of these follower guys left alive, and then after that there are only wolves and some Millwood knights in this area. So we kind of cleared it. Follower torch here. I don't know if I have the stats for it actually, but I believe it does quite a bit more damage. Yeah, it has fire damage to it, and it actually scales with pyromancy stats. So you will, if you're a pyromancer, this will outdamage a regular torch by the long shot, but chances are you probably end up using it as your main weapon. Down below has a few of those Millwood knights up there, so I'm not going to go there quite yet. I still have another shortcut to unlock. Here we get this guy's hammer. I don't want to bother with him in such a small space. So I'm just gonna go ahead and run past most of these guys. And make my way straight to the shortcut. Now over here, these dudes, as I mentioned before, you can actually farm them for heavy gems. I've already purchased their equipment. You get it from the Captain's Ashes that we picked up in a previous video. So I'm just gonna go ahead and I think I should kill this guy. And that did not work out how I planned. So yeah, fuck it. There's a shit ton of these guys in this area, so I'm just gonna make my way through and run past all this nonsense. Pick up Earthseeker, that's the great axe the guy's using. Strength, faith, weapon. And what have we got over here? Solve a Crestfallen Knight. And I'm outie. I picked up all the items here. I'm not gonna fuck around with four of these guys. And they're still going off. Okay, and now this shortcut actually, this passageway, I should say, takes us all the way to Ariandel's chapel. These flies are actually quite annoying. They cause bleed, so do keep your blood red moss clumps handy. In typical Souls fashion, this is a trap setup. First things first, I'm just gonna go ahead and unlock the shortcut to where we've met Sister Friday. And as you can see, this is Ariandel's chapel. Sister Friday is still right there. And can't access the boss fight for an Ariandel quite yet. Gotta just take care of a couple more shortcuts here. It's right here, a little hidden passageway. This way we don't have to drop down from up top and get ganked by all these flies. Although there's going to be so many of them, it will still be quite annoying. They have a grab attack and they have a spit attack. They're both cause bleed. This is the spit attack right there. And now the bleed builds up, so you have to use the blood red moss clump to get rid of the worms, or you're gonna have to go ahead and burn them off with a torch. That's up to you. Again, another reason to love the mace, strike damage is always been a beast in Souls series PvE. That was a case with Demon Souls where strike weapons like mace did most damage, not just because they're so powerful, but also because a lot of enemies are weak to strike damage, so kind of a little bonus to using them. Pick up Willem's armor right here. And this right here unlocks the passageway to the boss fight. Sister Friday is not amused.
As ashes will be, ever seeking fire.
Alright, and blood gem right in the middle of the area here. And I think we're pretty well off at the moment. There is another hidden area. Is it right here? One of these side doors. I'm gonna go ahead and kill these crystal lizards real quick. And down below, there's gonna be an NPC. Don't know if I should fight her right now. I'm kinda low on Estus, but I figure I can take her. Here we go, Silver Cat Ring. That is if I remember how to get there. I think I got a drop down here. Right? Maybe? Yeah, we're in the right way. Okay, and we'll get another Pyromancer Flame. This one is notorious for doing higher damage up close. Let's see, what should I wear for my ring? Cast this one in that. Yeah, there's gonna be another NPC here. The Pyromancer Danel. Fucker. Bad stamina management by me. Got way too aggressive there. Alright, who wants to take bets that I will fall down on my way to get there? Because that is typically the case. Alright, can I drop down without dying? I believe I can. And good thing about this is that I don't have to fight these flies all over again since I've done everything in this area. Entirely sure how I got here. Alright, Horned Ring goes fuck you. And Dual Charms goes again, fuck you. Can't outtrade the maze. There we go. Well, again, sometimes it's easy like that, and I guess that's what I should have done the first time around. Get a floating chaos pyromancy, and this is it. If you guys don't remember, this is the area where you fight Priscilla in the first Dark Souls in the painted world of Ariamis. So, and if you look close enough, this looks to be like her, well, at least what's left of her dead body here, unfortunately. So, a little nod to Priscilla, a favorite waifu from Dark Souls. So here it goes, guys. This is going to be the end of my second episode. Thank you very much for watching, and I will be tomorrow with Chapter 3. Thank you and have a great day.